Earthworm Jim is a cult classic video game that still brings out the nostalgia in retro video gamers today. In order to find out where Earthworm Jim came from, we have to look at the toy company Playmates Toys. Playmates Toys had previously made a huge name for themselves when they produced the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles action figure lineup. However, they didn't own the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles brand and wanted to start their own franchise. Playmates Toys loved the Sonic the Hedgehog series and decided to develop a video game franchise instead of action figures. They would get together with David Perry, who had previously worked on the video game Disney's Aladdin at Virgin Games, and have him start up the video game development company Shiny Entertainment. David Perry would see a sketch by Douglas Tenapal, another video game developer, and the sketch would impress him so much that Shiny Entertainment would buy the rights to the character, and Earthworm Jim was well on his way. Perry, Tenapal, and the rest of the Shiny Entertainment employees would get started on developing the video game. Tenapal would handle game and level design and Earthworm Jim's voice, and Perry and the rest of the team would work on creating other characters and game mechanics. Since the team had previously been so restricted while working on video games at Virgin Games such as 7-Up's Cool Spot, they decided to go a little crazy with the game's atmosphere, world, and characters. The game would end up being a comedy satire with many wacky worlds and bosses, and even had one boss called Princess What's-Her-Name, based on the numerous Damsels in Distress video game characters that needed saving over the years. The game would originally release for the Sega Genesis in 1994 and for the Super Nintendo the same month, but slightly delayed. The games were virtually the same except for some different graphics, backgrounds, and special effects in the Super Nintendo version. But missing were some sound effects and a Sega Genesis level titled Intentional Distress. At the time, the stated reason for the extra level in the Genesis version was space on the cartridge. The Genesis version was more easily compressed and had room for the bonus level. However, Nick Brody, a video game designer that worked on Earthworm Jim, stated in an interview that Sega had requested Shiny Entertainment add an exclusive level to the Sega version for a reduced cartridge cost. Nick stated the extra level was designed in one night and the code was completed and the level tested the same day the game was sent to be printed for the consoles. The marketing department for Earthworm Jim would release one of the most wacky commercials ever, but it really fits the game's sense of humor.
This is the story of Earthworm Jim video game. In outer space, a sweet evil sovereign lost the Queen's cyberspace suit. Well, it smooshes.
We're in a slimy Earthworm Jim! And blammo! He becomes a super-powered hero. He takes out that precious dog. Then that stupid worm goes onto the planet.
He even tries mucus
bungee jumping. And if that doesn't stop him, maybe the battle with Queen festering sweaty sulfur upon Quill. Earthworm Jim from Playmates.
The game would go on to receive multiple ports and even a special edition released for the Sega CD with a new level and new music. It would also receive a special edition through the Sega channel for a contest dubbed the Great Earthworm Jim Race. This version included a secret room which, when reached by the first 200 players, would display a password and toll-free number. Those that called the number were awarded prizes. The game would receive very positive reviews and would receive Electronic Gaming Monthly's Best Genesis Game of the Year award in 1994. To finish us off, here are some quick facts for your enjoyment. A port was being developed for the Atari Jaguar but was never completed, and as of today, the prototype and all code are lost. The game received an animated series that ran from 1995 to 1996, and Earthworm Jim himself was voiced by Dan Castellaneta, who is more famously known for voicing Homer Simpson from the show The Simpsons. Earthworm Jim is a playable character in the Nintendo 64 game Clay Fighter 63 1/3. The in-between bonus levels are called Andy Asteroids and are named after Andy Astor, who was a member of the game's development team. Thanks for joining me on a brief history of Earthworm Jim, and as always, make sure to subscribe, click the notification bell, and follow me on social media. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time. Rod here with Zivivi Entertainment. Before I get out of here, make sure to check out Digital Break for some awesome content creators. Digital Break is a one-hour block on local TV that premiered in April. They are taking talented YouTube creators and airing their content on local TV. So make sure to follow and like their Facebook page. Thanks everyone, I'm out.